So I thought this morning we'd just take a little walk out into the orchard again, since it's been like a month, I think, since I posted that last orchard video. Link down in the description below. And there's been some more developments. We got some blueberries still going on. We've got grapes galore and a couple roses to show you. Let's go check it out. Look at these beauties. This rose is called Bewitched and it's absolutely gorgeous. I love that pink and it's got a wonderful smell to it. Here we are again, out in the orchard. There it is, grapes, blueberries, raspberries. And then we've got all of our apple trees over there. There's the strawberries, but I want to show you something this morning. We're going to walk over here. Let's go over here, guys. Let's go over here. Because I came out here the other day, and I was still, actually I come out here every day, but I was really impressed with what I saw. Look at this. We are still, we're in the, what is today? Today is August 8th, and we're still getting tons of blueberries. Look at this. It's incredible. Tons of blueberries. All over, they're getting towards the end. You can see there's a couple that are drying up there from the heat, but there's still some really good ones. I ate some last night and they're still just awesome, man. Really sweet. And in fact, it's some of the best ones right now because they're just getting to the end and they're full of sugar. More right in there. But look at this one right here. I want to show you my top varieties here. I mean, look at how loaded that is. I can't even eat them fast enough. I've been eating tons of these things. We've got a few over in this little clump here. Lots of blueberries left, but look at this. These are my best producers. You guys want to go get blueberries? Let's see if I can find the tags on them. If you guys want to go get blueberries, here's one of them. These are my best producers that taste the best. And this is the Pacific Northwest Zone 8B. Here we go. Toro Northern High Bush. I'm super excited about this one. We've had it for several years now, and it, I mean, you can see it's towards the end now, but all of these had clusters, big clusters of blueberries. And you saw them, I made that other video. I've been eating them like crazy. That one produced gigantic blueberries. Here, let's read about it a little bit. You guys probably want to know some more. Toro Northern High Bush, select full sun or partial shade with well-draining soil. Let's see, what kind of, it says zone 4 to 8, season, mid-season, size, large, mildly sweet. And that sounds like it's describing it just about right. Mature size, 4 to 6 foot, stocky, upright. So it's got a real good branching too. It's a solid, shrub there. Let's look at this one. I was real excited about this one, Chandler. And you know what? It's performing like I wanted it to. There it is. Chandler, another northern high bush. And we'll see, this is also zone 4 to 8, mid to late. So you can tell it's mid to late. That one was mid, the Toro, and this is mid to late. It's the Chandler, and this guy's just about done, and we're getting later into the summer, and here we are, loaded up with berries. So this is what's so cool, having all these 16 different varieties. This one came on, tons of blueberries. I was eating them like crazy. This one came on later, and I'm still eating tons of blueberries. I love having them go all summer long. The thing is, when you got all these different varieties, they're able to cross-pollinate, so you get massive loads of berries on all of the plants, and I really like that aspect. Do you need 16 different varieties? Well, probably not. You could probably get away with having just these two, or maybe 3 or 4 varieties, and you'd get the same results. But it's fun trying all these different things out. This is very large, which they are large. I thought the Toro were just as large, but very large, full, robust flavor. They are, I can tell you, wish you could taste them. Mature size, 5 to 7 foot, so a little bit bigger. Lightly spreading. Fall color, wine orange. Well, they all turn a little bit wine orange, yellowy kind of color, which is really cool. That's another neat aspect of these blueberries, is they've got beautiful fall colors. So anyway, tons of blueberries. I'm gonna have to come back out here tonight. We're gonna make a blueberry cobbler, guys. Would you like to see that recipe? I have got, oh man, hold on. Let me talk to you guys here. There we go. I have got the most fantastic, oh, there's Ruger. I've got the most fantastic cobbler recipe in existence. It's actually, so my dad is a machinist by trade. And I grew up in Phoenix, Arizona, and he worked at a casting foundry. He actually worked on aerospace parts, high tolerance parts. He's a machinist, and he knew a guy down there, and his name was Leon, and he printed out a copy, wrote it all out by hand, and made a copy of it for my dad. Actually, he wrote it out by hand and just gave it to my dad. So this recipe goes back decades and decades, right? It's back in the early 80s, maybe even the late 70s, something like that. Anyway, he wrote it out. We had it in our family. My dad made this all these years, but it was called Leon's Peach Cobbler, right? And I don't know if he invented the thing or not, but it's a really simple recipe. And over the years, we've used peaches. We've used pineapple. I've made a copy. I finally scanned it into a computer when computers came around, because they weren't always around for us, you know? You remember that? And I scanned it into a computer. I made copies of it. My brother's got it. I've got it. My dad's got it. It's an awesome cobbler recipe, and you can put peaches, pineapple, blueberries, blackberries, anything you want in it. Anyway, if you guys want that, we're going to have to do a video on that. And I'm going to have to show you how to make Leon's Peach Cobbler. All right, back to the video. So we've got some massive blueberry bushes. These guys are done. This was the pink popcorn my girls picked out. It's a pink color, really good tasting blueberry. It's really not a blueberry, but it is a blueberry. I don't know what to tell you. But that one is a big scraggly bush. We're going to have to cut some of these branches down. It's supposed to get huge. Do I even have a tag anymore for that thing? Anyway, I probably do somewhere down in there. I know there's got to be one. But the point is, I wanted to show you my best producing ones. So we've got Toro. We've got Chandler. Heck, I might just propagate these guys. We'll do a video on that at some point. I'm going to propagate these guys and just plant them all over the place. And then we've got this one. And it's been producing like crazy this summer. Also a good tasting, but a smaller one. This is called Coville. I don't know if it was produced or invented or whatever in Coville, Washington, but that variety is producing really big time. And I like that one too. You can see it's kind of a more upright plant. It's got smaller leaves. It's not as robust plant, but it's got lots of berries. The berries are smaller to medium size, but they're sweet and they're good. And then, he's not doing so hot. We're going to have to give him a little help. This one right here, I hate to say this because I don't want to give you the wrong impression, but I'm most disappointed in. I had such high hopes for this blueberry, and it might do great in colder climates. I don't know, but it's not doing very well here. And maybe it's just this particular plant. Maybe I need to take more cuttings and try and start them fresh from cuttings, but Duke blueberry. And sometimes certain plants don't do as well in certain areas, and if you plant them somewhere else, then they do great. So I'm gonna have to play around with that one, because I had really high hopes for it, but it's just never performed here. But anyway, really awesome, guys. But let's take you over here real quick. I want to show you something that is just so awesome. Look at this. All of these our grapes, guys. Look at this. Zero in on some of this. All of these grapes, man. Who says you cannot grow grapes in Washington State? Look at that. August 8th, they're just forming like crazy. Look at this bunch. They're so young, and they're still just, you know, forming and growing. They got to get a lot bigger than that. But look at this everywhere I go. Hanging down here. Look at all these grapes all throughout. Look at that right there, hanging down there. We're gonna have so many grapes. I'm gonna have to learn how to make wine. I'm not a wine drinker. When I was in Italy in the Navy, I spent 6 months there. I tried to like wine. I don't know, maybe it's like beer. You just gotta keep cramming it down your throat until you like it. But I fell in love with grappa, and a lot of people don't like that. But I think it's a sweet wine. I don't even know, but I really liked grappa. Let me show you this though, guys. So many grapes, but I think this is so cool, the difference. I've got these two varieties growing in next to each other. Now, this right here is a Romali white seedless grape. That's the one you've been looking at. And it's growing huge. It's growing huge. It's taking up a massive area all the way across here. I need to get this. I need to make a better setup for that. But right over here, we've got a different variety, and it's a red. Let's see if we can find what variety that is. Dig down in here so that you guys can see if you do want to grow it yourself. There it is, flame red seedless grape. There it is, flame red seedless. But look at this. This is what I like about this one. It's so cool. So this is the white one. It's so growing out of control and taking over. It's growing into the red. But here is, this is from the red. You can see the difference. See how they're round? They're not red yet, obviously. It's not late enough in the season, but they're round right now. And these guys, these white ones, are more of an oblong shape. I think that's so cool. I like the difference. Here's another one. Here's more flame flame red. Look at that, the round. They're really neat. It's really pretty. There's not as many. It's not as vigorous a plant, but it is vigorous enough to produce quite nicely. Let's look here. Let's look here. Okay. So we got more of those round ones. See that? Isn't that cool? I just really think that's neat, guys. I really think that's neat. Anyway, tons and tons of grapes. Let me back up and give you guys a whole shot of this because we're so zoned in. You're probably going, Mike, I can't see any of it because you're standing right next to it. There it is. There it is. All those grapes. Look at that. I don't even know what I'm going to do with all of them. It's insane. I'm going to have to do some grape propagation. That doesn't happen, though. You like that, huh, Clem? Clam. That was my dad's chicken. That's Henry. Anyway, too much coffee. I'm going to have to prune these guys back. We'll have to do some grape propagation. That happens in late winter. There he goes. Kind of like the same time as the green giants. So, in their hardwood cuttings. So maybe you can do softwood, I don't know. Probably be a lot easier as hardwood though for grapes, but isn't that neat? Just tons of grapes. I wanna continue it all the way down. Somewhere along the back there, I think I wanna do some blackberries and just kind of manage them and keep them tied up. And I've got those thornless varieties I've showed you before, a black satin and I can't remember the other one, but they'll be able to pollinate each other. But I've got some kiwis too. I haven't decided where I want those yet, but look at those grapes. Kind of makes a nice wall. It makes it a nice little private garden back in here. We need to get this thing surrounded all the way. Our little Shangri-La. All right, so that was a fun, quick little tour for you guys. I hope you guys liked it. If you liked it, hit the like button, but only if you liked it. Subscribe if you want to follow along, and let me know down below if you guys want to see a video about making the Leon's Peach Cobbler. I think that would be fun. Anyway, have a fantastic week, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Adios!